Hi everybody, welcome to Kraaft It Live. I am your host Heather and I am extremely excited to be here today because we have got some fun things in store today. Basically, I just learned what I'm going to be doing, so that's how fun it is. I have kind of set up a, you know, pre-done, so it's a little bit drier, but I only just did it like within the hour. So we're going to see how this goes because I'm pretty much winging it. Might even ask for some suggestions from you guys out there, but going to be exploring DecoArt Media Fluid Acrylics, and we are going to be doing some texture and stuff like that. So we'll see how it goes, and hopefully we'll have some fun along the way. I think that we've got a few people joining us in the audience, don't we, Sylvia?
Oh, yeah, yes. Yeah, it grows more as the show starts progressing, too.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Yeah. So as we come into these things, we always start out with the audience who shows up early. Thank you guys who do that because the chatter in the over in the text area is quite hilarious and it really does set the tone for how the rest of the show goes. So yeah. Thank you guys for showing up early enough to have a conversation and to enjoy each other's company. It's like you've gone to the big theater and you're milling around in the lobby before the lights go down and then y'all settle in to watch the show, but I know better. After last week, there's not a lot of show watching going on. It's a lot more chit-chat. I know that.
Yeah. Yeah. For those of you who missed the Not So Live last week, it was unbelievable. The chatter going on back and forth and everything, because we all showed up at the normal scheduled time to watch with Heather because she got to be in the audience, which she doesn't get to do very often. And it was hysterical. It was a good time.
It was really hard for me. I actually did not even watch the video, which didn't matter. I mean, I saw the video when I made it, but I remember there being questions and I'm going, I don't even know what that's about because I paid no attention to the video. It was all about the chit chatter. And we will not even talk about what I did with my typing. So just move on, okay? So we'll just move on with that. But anyway, I want to set up my camera angles and stuff. If you don't mind, Sylvia, I'm going to put the camera on you and you'll welcome everybody. Okay.
Okay. Sounds great. Okay. I want to say hi to all the people that are watching right now. Nanette and Kathy, Sheila, Peg. Hi, Peg. It's been a while since you've been able to join us. Maria, who's Rhea, Jazzy, who's Jane, Vicky, Anamati, Michael T, Haley, Carol S, Mary Sewell, Lisa, Linda K, and Linz. We're so glad that you guys are here joining us today, and it's going to be another fun show. And I want to put up the today's message. If I can, today's message, God calls us into a service and promises to help us. He called his 12 disciples to him and gave them authority. That's from Matthew 10:1. And then also I want to put up this other verse, this other comment. This is from Linz, this about last week. I watched the show 3 times because it was that good. It was for not a live show. It was fantastic.
What was really funny to me was us trying to record that thinking of the live.
Oh, gosh.
Know, yeah. That was interesting. We decided we can't do the show without the audience. We need
That's
the audience.
So true. That is so true. It's just like Heather and me sitting in a tree, you know.
As boring as that can be.
It's not that it's boring, okay? It's just that, you know, it just... We were kind of lost for words. We didn't know what to say. I mean, because we're so used to responding to everybody in the audience. So it was fun. It was fun.
Yeah, I have to agree. All right, I'm trying really hard to get the camera set up. So just bear with me here while I get my colors going.
Ooh, napkin time.
Well, I'm just got that there for color. For color choices. Okay, let's see. Does that look okay? I think
Looks
so.
Great.
I think I bumped the camera though. Yeah, okay, there we go. So that was just for color options. So, all right. So I have got a 11 by 17 canvas panel. No, I'm sorry, 11 by 14, my bad. 11 by 14 canvas panel. I buy these like in a 3-pack so that I can save a few dollars. But, and then I've just got a few pieces of text paper. And we're just going to tear it up and attach it. And I'm going to use my soft matte gel to do that. But today's technique is a little different than you normally see me use. Where's my paintbrush? I have one brush that I use for this portion of the, for the gluing portion, you know. Let's see. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tear this into three. Let's just go in half, and then we'll tear this in half. And maybe we'll tear this a little bit, too. Yeah, that'll be good. Okay, so normally I want to stick it all down really well. But not today. So this is what I'm going to do today. Notice that I'm not really putting on a great layer, and I've not gone to all the edges. That's on purpose. And you're gonna have to tell me I'm out of frame and all that jazz, but okay, as we go. But I'm just gonna use this to really make sure I get it spread out as best I can. It's just an old credit card or hotel key room thing, whatever. But notice that there's still edges that are lifting.
Yes.
I want that. That's on purpose.
On purpose? Okay.
Purpose, yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. Alrighty.
New word for the day. All right, so we're just going to do this with all of these papers.
Apparently London got snow, and they're talking about snow, and I guess Wyoming got snow too, so then I had to chime in because we had a cold front move into Arizona yesterday, and we got snow up in Prescott and Flagstaff, along with something they call grumble, or I don't know what it is, but I used to call it sleet or hail, but now there's some kind of technical word for it. I don't know what it is, but that came in too. I don't know.
Sounds like the noise people make when they have that happen to them.
Brumble. I don't know what they called it, but I was like, what? It's hail. Okay, it's hail.
Wow. All right, so I've just got basically three old pieces. This is dictionary. This is a play. This is, I don't know, some kind of almanac or something. I don't know. And the whole purpose of this is to glue some texture down, but not 100%, because once it's dried or mostly dried, we're going to rip it off. Rip off what's not stuck down. Oh, and I forgot what I was doing. Put it on the paper, Heather. don't talk and try to do this at the same time. Usually I do pretty good with that, but not today, apparently. All right, so the reason why I've chosen text paper for my background is because the paints that we are using today, the DecoArt Media fluid acrylic line, are very transparent. So this is going to be a load of fun to be able to see all this stuff in the background.
Yeah.
And you'll notice that I'm overlapping, I'm going all over the place, and I'm going in different directions. Again, just to add. But I'm doing a whole lot of paper because we are going to rip probably, I want to say 30%, 20 or 30% of it off.
Really?
Yeah. It just works out that way. So put on more than you really expect to use. This is where those books that you get at like the thrift store or something, or if you've purchased the pages, the book pages that we sold in the store, if you've purchased those before, then you get it. You get a really good amount of pages.
Yeah, you do.
To use. And this is, I don't want you to hoard this stuff. This stuff needs to be utilized. Don't just hoard it. Some of you like to hoard your supplies as if you'll never get them again, and then you never use them. And what's the point then, right?
Oh, well, that's what we do.
I know. And then you like to yell at me when you see, when you think I've wasted mine. So.
Well, it's my job.
Some of you are really good at your job. That one's probably going to get ripped off in the end there, which is fine. All right, let's see. Just a little bit more here and there. I like these yellowish pages. Those are pretty cool. I don't know if you're seeing all this or not seeing all this. But.
Yeah. You could slide it down just a hair if you so chose. Okay. Now we can see the top.
There we go. All right. So okay. There it is at that stage. I'm going to glue one more piece down. Let's just put this down here. Let's go this way with it. Okay, so there it is at this stage. And there's a lot of parts that are still sticking up. But it needs to be dry before you do the next stage. So bear with me as I heat this up. The drier it is, the better this next part of it will be. I'm probably going to go too fast and take off too much because, you know, it's live, so we get a little bit antsy. Okay, the truth is I get antsy. I think that time really goes by a lot faster in this hour than any other hour of my life, honestly.
Yeah, I agree.
What normally takes me an hour to do something, on this show, it seems to take me two or three, so... This stuff does dry pretty fast, and we only put it on the bottom. We didn't put it over the top of anything. So we should be able to work with it pretty fast. But look at all those corners that are curling. That you could even leave it like that if you like that.
Yeah, I like that kind of texture.
Texture, yes. Texture. All right, so I think it's feeling pretty good, good enough for me to move on. Okay, so anywhere that I have these lift-ups, I'm just going to kind of tear it gently, and that'll just add to the texture that we have going on. Turn it in different ways so you get kind of a different tear happening. Like I said, some of this is going to come completely off. Some of it will stay. It just depends on how wet it is. Some of that's still a little wet there, but it just adds to it. And I really like how it looks so torn, you know?
Yeah. I like the way it sometimes you peel part of it off and it leaves a little film over and, you know, kind of blurs the words in behind and stuff. I like that.
Exactly. Exactly. And that's what we want. We just want a layer of, I don't know, I've overused this word, but I'm going to say it anyway, texture.
Michael Thomas is saying texture and yob are two of my favorite words today. Thanks.
All right. So that's good enough. Wait, one more. I saw this here. Yeah, that has to go. Okay. So that's good enough right there. And so you see what we pulled it back to? It was totally covered and now it's not. So,
yeah.
All right. So leave the rest of it as it is. Good enough for me. Now the next step is to take some gesso. I'm going to use Dina Wakely's white gesso because it's handy. A brush. And a spray bottle of water. I like this gesso for this stuff, for these washes, because it isn't very thick. So it's quite nice to do a wash that will push back and make most of this the same color, close enough anyway. It makes that really yellow brownish paper much more the color of the rest of the pages. So, and it doesn't have to be perfect. And I also want to be able to put a ground on this so that my fluid acrylics will slide and glide real well. So
slide and glide, slide,
slide and glide. And if you feel like you've put too much on, you can add water and spread it around with your brush, or you can grab a baby wipe and wipe it back. So if it's covering too much, like I just did it here on purpose, you can see that it just totally obliterated that paper. Mm-hmm. So there's two things you can do. You can either squirt it with some water and kind of spread it out like that. Or you can grab a baby wipe and go over it so that you take some of that gesso off a little bit so you're not totally obliterating the whole thing.
Cool.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So from there we dry just real quickly. Doesn't have to be perfectly dry, especially because I've already prepared one. So this next step will have to dry overnight for best results. But you know me, I'm too impatient for that. So I use the heat tool, and I actually really like the heat tool and what happened with the heat tool, but we'll get to that in a second. So gesso away. And now I'm going to use texture paste. This is graphite texture paste from Finnebear. And I love this stuff because it has these sparkles in it and everything that you can't really see. Right now it's like gray goo. And then I'm just going to go in with our palette knife and just kind of draw a horizon line with the palette knife. All right, and then let's add a mountain shape here. And just using the palette knife, we're just going to create mountain peaks. And you can be, you know, as detailed with this as you want to be or not. Make it look a little less pointy there, a little more natural. Some add some like texture in there. I feel bad saying the same word over and over again, but add some texture in there with the palette knife, and hopefully you guys can see all that going on.
Looks great.
All right, and I'm just going to pull it down straight across. All right, there we go. That's our mountain scene. And now I will tell you, I did do one more thing, I guess, before I get that far. Hold on. Put this stuff away and wipe off the palette knife. We're going to use that again, but this time with modeling paste. And if you don't have all these things, don't worry about it. Lots of different things make texture, like heavy gesso. You can use heavy gesso for the wash as well as for texturizing. You don't have to have this. You can also use modeling paste for the mountain and not have to worry about having the graphite. And just add some glitter to it. You know, you can do different things. You'll end up with a different result, but it'll be your result. So it doesn't have to be, you don't have to have the same products. Part of the reason why I got out of, you know, doing the store, which I'm considering going back into, I must be crazy. That's all there is to that. But part of the reason is because I don't want you to feel like you have to buy all these things in order to do what we're doing. There's so many different options out there, and use what you have. Stop spending money, because most of you are spending money and not doing much. I need you to do more, not spend. All right, so I'm just going to lift that off. It's a very thin layer. Just cleaning off my stencil real quick. That is a very thin layer, so it'll dry pretty quickly. Clean up these edges just like this. All right, and there is our piece ready for drying time.
Well, that's so, real pretty, Heather. Very
thank
pretty.
You. And through the magic of television, which if we were on TV, this one is mostly dry. And you can tell it's turned from gooey gray to a black with that shimmer shine in there. So I'm going to show you the other one. It's kind of a gray with no shimmer, really. And black with lots of granite-looking shimmer in there.
Looks just like a mountain.
All right. Sounds good. That's what we're aiming for. Okay, so the next thing from here, I do want to tell you that I did use my heat tool, and I did kind of sit still in a spot for a long, long time and let it really bubble because I was trying to make sure I was ready for the show. But as it turns out, that added quite a bit of texture. So can you see all of that?
Did it bubble it or what?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, it's dimensional right there. I'm just trying to get it to where you guys can see. Can you see that? It kind of did in some places here and there. So,
cool.
Yeah, it's quite cool. All right, so this is ready. We got it all ready. Okay, now it's time for some fun. Let's get some fun going. I'm going to use, this is all that DecoArt Media Fluid Acrylic. So we're going to start at the bottom, and I'm going to just put down a layer, basically a line of paint. And with a paintbrush, boy, I was not at all prepared for this. I don't even have my bucket of water. Hold on. Do you have any comments you want to bring up while I'm looking for a bucket of water?
Very, very deep discussion going on about some of the health issues that some of the people in the community have. And I think that's one of the great things about our community is that we're there to help support everyone.
Boy, everybody has always been so supportive of the times mm-hmm. that there's been issues for each of us. So many of us struggle. I'm just glad we have each other to reach out to and to take care of when we're having problems or family members or whatever. It truly is a community.
Yeah, it sure is.
All right, so I've just got some water here. My water looks gross. I'm moving that off camera. It's clean water, just the bucket's not. Okay, and I'm just going to add some water to each of these areas. And we'll see what happens. Maybe some sprays. I just want to see what will happen.
Michael wants to know if that's actually vodka in there instead of water.
No, it's actually water. This green needs to be mixed in with the water a little bit more than just water added to it like that.
Mix it up a little bit. That's very sweet. I don't mind. I want to put this one up. This is just very sweet. This is the best family anyone can get. Isn't that just sweet?
Yeah, and that says a whole lot about each and every one of you out there. Okay, so I've got a piece of paper towel to keep myself from getting into the mountain with all this. It's not working out too well, is it? Oh, there we go. Dripping, dripping. I just had to turn it towards myself more. Ha! Huh. Who knew? All right, I like that. That's looking good. Drying time. And you'll notice how transparent these are, even if I don't add the water. So let's just do that. Let's leave it like this so they'll mix together. And then I'm going to add, this is green gold. And I'm not even going to clean off my brush. I'm just going to go in. Normally, I would have a palette for this kind of stuff. I don't know what I'm doing today.
Oh, I like how that mixes.
Yeah, me too. That's, I think I want to do more mixing on the canvas than in a palette. Yeah, that's what I'm going to say. It was totally on purpose. That's what I was trying to do. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Do you find that this fluid acrylic here from DecoArts is similar to the weight of the fluid acrylic from Golden?
It seems
just
that
the
way.
Weight of it. Okay.
It seems that way. You know, my experience with Golden is I've used one of their paints is all the quinacridone nicolazo gold. So I don't really have much experience with Golden to say, you know, to do full comparisons, but you know what I did buy? Oh, look at that. Can you guys see this?
Yeah, it looks great. Oh my God.
As it's going down there. Oh, I need to leave that up there. I know that's not very good for the camera, but man, that's pretty. I like that one.
Everybody's talking about your drippage too.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. Okay, so this is, we're going to go off topic while that drips a little bit. So quinacridone gold, so it's not nickel azole, so they didn't use that same terminology, but, and you know, I don't know anything about the terms or the words, right? I don't know anything about any of that, so, but this is their version of quinacridone gold, and the color is really cool, so maybe we'll, if we have time, we'll explore that compared to the other one and see what they're like.
Cool.
I don't think that anything really compares to them per se, you know, the golden acrylics, but if you can get something comparable that is a little less expensive, you might use it more. You might actually be able to buy it. In my case, that's my case. I'm not able to afford those.
Michael's so attempting to spell quinacridone.
Good. I can't wait to see how he does.
Oh, it's coming out real good.
Hey, Andrew's here.
Yeah, Andrew's here and Michael Daniel's
everyone,
here.
Everyone has to sing happy birthday to Andrew because today he is 73 years young.
Oh, believe it or not. But we can't sing that song.
No. I mean, you all just sing it. We won't hear it.
Okay, alrighty.
Yeah, I just want you all to sing it to him.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, people start singing, okay?
Ready, go. We'll wait. Oh, this is looking
okay, I'm
good.
Done.
You see those colors? Are you finished? Okay.
Yeah, I finished. Are you guys done?
All right, here we go. Look at that. I'm liking that. That's turning out pretty good. All right, let's do the same thing in the sky for blues. We have lots of blues. Let's see. Cerulean blue, thalo turquoise, and cobalt turquoise hue. Why do they have to give them so many complicated names, I wonder? And I'm going to just mix right here on the canvas because that seems like the most fun I've had in a long, long time. Okay, my water is very, very green.
Cool.
There's a lot of pigment in these, a lot of pigment. I'm just going to spray some water. Ooh, look at that.
Ooh,
look at that. Yeah. You know what? Let's spray with some more. Very, very wet.
They blend well, don't they?
Oh, they seem to. Look at what they're doing. Oh,
yeah.
I'm going to wear this. I didn't even put my apron on. Oh, man. I'm having a good time today.
Michael's going, so Andrew is 235 years old today. Congrats, dude.
Yeah, that Michael, he's kind of funny when it comes to Andrew's age. And Andrew's a pretty good sport because, you know, he has been around a long time.
That is so funny. I'm glad. I like the way those two play off of each other. It's really funny.
Yeah, some pretty good friends there.
Yeah. I liked when Michael wasn't, didn't you go visit Andrew and you were doing something outside and he didn't know that you were visiting him, but then he saw because it looked like what was right outside his window or something like that. I thought that was really cool.
Yeah, that was quite the, that's typical though. Michael is, he's just like that. He will play games and great surpriser.
Yeah, surprise from the park. That's what it was. Yeah, that was great.
Okay, let's see. There's some blue on the mountain. I think I want to get rid of that there. Blue on the mountain. There's some blue on the mountain. I don't think we'll get copyright on that because I don't think it's representing anything. It's just something I was making up.
As long as you don't do it to a specific tune, that would be appropriate
today. Yeah, I think
today.
It'd be okay. Right. Yeah. I'm pretty sure there's no robots listening to my voice. Other than to maybe shut me down for lack of ability to sing, but.
Yeah, Andrew said that was insane. That was fun when Michael surprised him. And Michael was with someone else too, right? Wasn't the two of you there?
Sheila.
It was Sheila. Yeah, yeah.
that was a good time. That was a good time to even be somebody watching.
It was.
Thankfully, they recorded part of it, so we did get to see some of that.
Yeah, yeah. I just want to say also that Beth Brown is watching, and Beth Brown is going to Donna Downey this weekend to do an in-person class with her.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh. I told her she has to take lots of pictures.
I want to also see if she will do like a, I might even watch a Periscope at that point if she would Periscope something. I've never yet watched one single Periscope. I've watched, you know, the parts of some, but not the whole thing. I would watch that, Beth, FYI.
And she doesn't even have Periscope, so that'll be a real trick. Oh, I'll be there.
Oh, okay. Okay.
No, we can watch it on my phone. There you go.
No, I thought you could watch on the computer. You can't?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh.
I thought you could. If they record it, I think you can. I don't know. I think it's just an app thing. I don't know.
Oh, all right.
We'll have to
fine.
Check that out.
Fine. Forget it. Doesn't matter if you do it or not then. Okay. So this I like so far. I almost think I could leave it just like this, but I'm not gonna. I think we're going to add. Can you still see everything through it though?
Look at how
transparent those are. So pretty.
They almost react like a watercolor, particularly up in the sky.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
So here is another color, and I'm just going to go in with a brush. I'm not going to add any water.
Now, what's that? Where did you get that paint?
It is called Blue Green Light.
Oh, okay.
And this is no water, so that you can see what happens.
See, Pega's saying, yes, you can watch. But just a video on the phone and upload is good, I guess.
Okay.
Oh, God. There's a conversation. They want to know the name of the mountain, but I can't pronounce the name that Andrew wanted. It's Dolphpool Mountain? I don't know if that has any significance or something. I don't know.
Knowing Andrew, it's whatever he decided to make up. So there you go. So you can still see. It's still, even though this one is more opaque.
Yeah.
It's still transparent. It has more opacity than the other one did, but the other greens did. But, and if I don't like it, just add some water.
Oh, he said dog poo. Okay.
Now that's just rude, Andrew. Go to your room. No more birthday party for you.
Yeah, no more celebration for you.
All right, time for a new paper towel. Just
Linda's just chirping right in there with Michael too. She's saying, "I think we should call that Andrew Mountain because it's nearly as old as him in real life." So she's
there
just chirping right in there with
there
Michael.
There you go. Sounds good. Okay, so let's see. What else do I want to add to this? I think we're going to add some more of this darker green in the foreground. See if we can, am I on screen still? Okay, good.
Yeah, Peg was asking, is that still the fluid acrylic color? Yeah, this is all Deco Art she's using today.
Yeah, I'm not using any other paints, promise.
Yeah.
All DecoArt fluid acrylics. Yeah. From the media line.
Michael says it looks like a black Nemo.
Black Nemo.
Yeah.
Okay.
Boy, it looks pretty.
Okay, so I don't know where to go from here. I feel like I need to add something to it, but I don't know what.
We want to take suggestions?
We can surely ask them for some. I don't know that I'll do it, but.
There you go. That's perfect. I love it. And Beth Brown wants to know if you're on their design team, DecoArts.
Oh, I don't think they have a design team, but definitely part of the Helping Artist program. Yeah.
Yeah.
They are a really good company. They support doing some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, they do.
This is the first, these are the first bits of product that I've received from them. And between their fabric paints, their these media fluid acrylics, and then the
Americana,
that's the other one. Yeah, I really enjoyed playing with them. So you'll see more and more things that I'm going to do. Okay, so I'm going to add some of this. This is interference.
Ooh.
We're going to see what it does. Before I get into it, let me just show you. There's five of these colors that I have. Uh-huh, sure. And let's see, there's a violet, a gold, turquoise, a blue, and magenta. And notice that they're all basically white. See that? And then when you put them on to like a dark surface, they change color depending on what you put them on. So my thought was, why don't we add them to some of these raised areas on the mountain here, just to give some highlights. I don't know if it'll work, but that's what we're going to try and do.
Now, what color is that one that you're using?
This one's gold. I thought that would be the best. And if I'm wrong, oh well, because that's what we're done. So now I will tell you this, we haven't really talked about it today, but this piece is going to be the giveaway to the patrons next month. So one lucky patron is going to get this, and then all the different levels get it as either an ATC or a 5x7 print. So if you're a patron, then you can look forward to receiving this. If you're not a patron, then you can still sign up. And this is all for next month's rewards mail out. That looks pretty good. I had to look up at the camera. But
yeah, that looks good.
I like that. I wonder what it's like as it dries. Let's see if drying makes any difference. Because it's kind of white, so I don't know if... Oh, wow. As it's drying, it's really turning gold.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah, now we can see it. Yeah. Michael wants to know what it interferes with. No, I mean, Andrew does. Light.
Apparently the light. It interferes with the light, apparently. All right, let's go up to the top up here where that doily is and bring out some of those highlights. On that doily, let's see. I got to clean my finger off.
See what that looks like on a lighter color. Yeah, because it definitely did turn gold on the mountain. You can definitely see that.
It did, yeah. So pay attention. Up here is where we're going to go next.
Let's see what happens.
Now, what's really cool about this is you notice that wherever I put the fluid paint, and it's dripped and everything, and it has that watercolor look to it. It is not moving around now that I'm getting it wet with other stuff because it's acrylic paint, so it's permanent.
Cool.
Well, Oh, I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this. Okay, let's see. Let's give that a dry. See where I can put it so that you guys will see what it's doing.
Okay, we have a question here from Linz, if I can.
Oh, good. People are going to participate with the show. Awesome. All right.
Yeah. There you go. Can you tell me if I wanted to do something similar, could you add color to pumice infused medium to give a little extra texture, or do you put paint under or over that medium?
Pumice, what's it called? Pumice?
She called it pumice infused medium.
Okay, so that would be like, is there like a golden version of texture paste that is pumice stone?
Yeah.
Okay, then it's the same as this without probably the black in it. So yeah, I would add black paint to the mixture while it's wet. I would mix it up to make it black. And then when it dries, it should be, assuming it's the same, when it dries, it should be the difference between this and this. You should end up with that. I don't know for sure, but it's worth experimenting and then telling us about it in the community for sure if it worked. So let's see if you guys can see that blue. You can definitely see that there's shimmer, right?
Yeah, but it's definitely different.
I don't know if you're seeing the different. It's a whole different color blue in my in person right here. That kind of stuff is not going to show up on the print, but it's still fun.
Michael, he always cracks me up. It's just like, I love these terms, pumice infused medium. Where else can you hear this stuff?
Exactly. All right, let's add a field of poppies or something down at the bottom. I feel like we need some warmth here.
Okay, nobody suggested anything. So if you don't want poppies, let us know.
Oh, it's too late. We're doing it anyway. So, all right, we're going to go with primary magenta and cadmium red hue. These are two very different red colors. One's more warm, one's more cool, right? Mm-hmm. That's going to give us some depth as we add some, like a field, basically, of flowers down here. Make sure this is dry enough. I don't see it. Oh, you guys, I can't wait to show you this.
Oh, you guys. Oh, yes.
Yeah, I love it. Should have worn my apron today, huh?
Yeah.
Then I would miss the opportunity to paint a shirt. Okay, so this is, I want to make sure this is dry because as long as it's wet, it will mix with the other wet paint. But once it's dry, it's permanent. So.
Yeah, make sure it dries.
Yeah. And for this, I'm also going to get a palette. See, eventually I do end up using something. Okay, let's just put this here. I feel like the colors on screen are a little more muted than I'm seeing in person. They're kind of dulled over there. Oh, I guess it might be time for an Instagram shot, maybe.
Yeah.
Let's do that, shall we? And then I'll take some pictures afterwards of that shimmer so you guys can see some more of that shimmer going on. But Instagram it. And boy, it takes a while. Okay. Oh, yeah, you guys are going to love that picture right there.
This was one of the fun things about last week's show is when you Instagram at the time of the recorded show that we were watching and you Instagrammed.
I told myself to Instagram. Okay, self out there. Now's the time to Instagram. Yeah, that was hilarious.
Everybody's liking that you painted on your shirt, you know, like Linda Kay's saying, getting serious now, huh?
Oh, yeah. We have a saying around here. It usually involves dinner time, that it's officially dinner time when mom has finally worn something from the meal. Same is true when I create as well. All right. So here's a little tip. Making a field of flowers look a little bit more real is easier if you remember that the things that you're closer to, like what's in the front of the painting, is bigger than the stuff that's in the back. And the stuff in the front has a lot more detail than the stuff in the back. So you can make this one appear to be much closer than this one here, than this group of them here, just by making them different sizes. And these are going to have a little bit more detail, so we'll add some more color to them and probably put in some black, some black centers on those ones that are even closer. So
cool.
And now I'm going into the quinacridone, no, I'm sorry, primary magenta, just to add another color. And when you think about the colors of flowers and the colors of different things in nature, even the same field of flowers is going to have different colored reds in there because of how the light hits them, how the light is streaming through some of the different layers of grass or leaves. So you want to keep that in mind when you're painting things of nature.
Nanette was saying that if you need to clean anything up, you can always use your journal cover.
True, and she would know, wouldn't she?
Yeah, she would definitely know.
Still cracks me up. She was trying to keep it clean for so long.
Yeah, I know.
You know, at least one page anyway.
We're talking about the journal that she's using for Donna Downey's Inspiration Wednesday. When she was making it, she was bound and determined that nothing was going to get on this journal cover. And now you ought to see it.
Yeah, and it lasted literally one lesson.
One lesson, right, yeah.
But it's absolutely gorgeous now, I think.
Yeah.
I'm glad that it didn't work. All right, so let's see if you can see all those.
Oh, those look good.
Oh, I'm sorry that they don't look the right color, but, you know, if you went to Instagram, you see the right coloring. We'll do it again. You got to see the poppies.
Oh, the color is really different.
Yeah, it's this whole camera setup thing. I'm still working on it, you guys. I'm sorry. Still working on it. All right, let's dry these so I can add some. Okay, now here's the thing. I only have Payne's gray. I don't have a black. You would think that I would have ordered a black, right? But I didn't. Not on purpose. I just wasn't thinking straight.
Payne's gray should work. It's pretty dark.
I hope so. And I'm going to get a smaller paintbrush for this part.
You could always use, you know, your pit pens, too, if you had to.
Yeah, I'm trying to really stay away from...
Yeah, keep it
all. I want to do everything with this paint and see if we can get her done. Yeah, that's going to work. Okay.
Okay. Lynn's is saying, if not, black gesso works too, which is true. But I think Payne's gray is going to work just fine. Yeah.
Can you see them?
Yeah, looks good.
You know, you guys being quiet out there makes me very nervous, just so you know.
You're just, Claret was asking what tag on Instagram, and it's Kraaft Shaak.
Yeah, it's just on my Instagram page, so I didn't put any words with the pictures at all. No tags, but... Yeah, I think this is coming okay. I think I want to add some more to the sky, though. It's that cerulean blue. And we'll use a little bit of that Payne's gray as well. Why not? Because it's out. Let's see.
Yeah, and Rhea made the suggestion that burnt umber and ultramarine blue makes a great black. It does. It makes a real good black. And yes, Claret, that goes for watercoloring too. You can mix those two for watercoloring. And when you made the remark that, you know, everybody's real quiet, Peg said, it's the poppies. They have a quieting effect.
That's funny. A lot of times I see people painting clouds and they want to add white. But sometimes you can really define clouds by just adding more sky around the not as bright area. And notice how there's no white. It's just where I didn't add a lot of blue. And now by going around with the blue, I'm actually defining where those clouds are. And then as it dries, I'll go back in and add a little bit more layer so it doesn't look as chunky. Some of this, I'm going to follow the natural layer that I see, or the natural lines that I see already.
Andrew's saying that poppies do have a quieting effect unless you're mainlining them.
Oh my goodness. He's just letting his 60s come out now.
Yeah, the wild child, huh? And Linz is saying that poppies are used a lot in remembrance. And yeah, they are here too, Linz. You know, we have that. We use poppies a lot for Memorial Day and for Veterans Day. And then you have that beautiful poem in Flanders Field.
This is very, very peaceful to me. I feel like I could just fall asleep right here.
They really define those clouds nicely, Heather.
Thanks. Okay, this is Kraaft It Live. We are live, but we don't say much while we're painting, apparently.
That's okay, we understand.
It's getting harder and harder. Oh, yeah?
Looking at it on Instagram, and boy, the color is so good there.
Yeah, I'm really not understanding what's going on with my settings on the computer anymore. I've really got to get it worked on, and I just have not had the ability to do that. So I'm hoping.
It's only as good as what mine is giving back to me too. You know, any monitor is giving back. So.
Yeah, you're right. But at least it would look good on my computer would make sense. You know, it could at least look like it does here. That's what I'm hoping, but yeah.
Rhea's saying that she's having a blast. She loves it when you just paint.
Well, that's good, because that seems to be what I'm doing at the moment. Not much else. Okay, I think I like that.
That's very pretty, very pretty.
I might even add a few more of these poppies down here because let's just add some more paint because we've got this huge blank space now that I just feel like it needs something.
Andrew wants to know if you would accept heavy breathing instead of silence.
On occasion, yes. It really does depend on my mood, of course, but yeah. Yeah, that looks a little better. I like that
very
better.
Pretty. Yeah.
And finally, I don't know where we're at with time because I'm not paying any attention, but finally I think what I'm going to do.
4 minutes.
Oh, that's all? Okay.
That's
well,
all. Yeah, yeah. And Michael came up with the best. It's Mama and the Poppies.
Just sticking with it. Yeah, we're just sticking with an entire theme today. Okay.
Yeah, right, exactly.
All right, I just exploded paint all over myself.
Shocking. Oh, no. What color?
It's a beautiful phthalo green blue.
Ooh.
Yeah. All I meant to do was give myself just a tiny drop and it exploded everywhere. Anyway, we're going to just go in here and give some of these ones in the front a little bit more of a stem.
Oh, you just made Andrew's day. Yay, a mess!
I know. Why do you like that so much, I wonder? Seems. I think Andrew likes the mess more than he likes my actual paintings, to be honest with you. I realize I could be wrong, but I doubt it.
Oh, people are asking about AKP, Heather.
Oh, I'm sorry. AKP is not going to be an option today because I've got to get to the post office. I have Patreon rewards to put out, and they're all ready to go right behind me. So, unfortunately, not today. And next week, everybody, I don't know if everyone's aware of this or not, but next week we're going to be live on location. Still haven't decided if we're doing it at your house or my grandma's.
Yeah, I know.
But don't tell my grandma anybody because she doesn't know I'm coming. I'm going to surprise her with the visit. My parents don't know either. So if you could just not tell anybody right now anywhere that I'm coming to Arizona, that'd be great. All right, I think that's good enough.
Looks great.
I was wondering about maybe adding some of this interference to some of the poppies, but I think that might be too much.
Yeah, I think it's fine.
I like having a little bit of interference up there. I might add a little more to some of these clouds. Let's just see what it's like.
Okay.
I know we said we're going to say goodbye, but look. Just hold
on. Well,
that.
That's okay because, you know, we got some discussion going over here. Linz is waiting for Andrew's beauty tips today.
Oh, yeah. Well, you can't expect him to do it all the time, guys.
But he's very happy because you made a beautiful painting and a mess. So what more could he ask for today?
Well, happy birthday, Andrew.
Yes.
So now I'm just going into the top of these clouds and just adding a little bit at the top of them. And maybe when the light catches, it'll look good. I don't know. We'll see. I may have just ruined the whole thing, but who knows? Can you see it? Can you see that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's the cloud with the silver linings. Oh, that's perfect.
That's funny. Silver linings.
Very pretty. Now, is that a different interference you're using?
It's the same blue one that's up here, so you can kind of see that there's blue there,
okay,
right?
I thought that was gold that you put on the top one. No, blue?
No, and then it's the same blue, but it's a little different because it's on a white background. No, I used gold and I used blue.
Oh, okay. That really makes those clouds look wonderful.
Isn't that neat?
Wow.
And that interference is all part of the media line. Kind of cool stuff. Depends on what you put it on, you know. Of course, when you look at it straight on, look right here. You almost can't see anything.
Yeah.
And then.
There you go. Yeah. Oh, excellent.
So it's like it doesn't exist, and then there it is.
There it is.
All right, so that's pretty much it. I'm going to let that dry. I'll take a picture, so look for it on Instagram. I'll be writing a blog post with all the colors that I used and everything.
Excellent.
And hopefully enjoyed this. And then we'll be giving this away in May. I think it's the 12th of May is when we do our Patreon-only hangout, and one lucky patron will get to win this for their monthly support. And if you're not a patron yet and you'd like to be and be in on getting this piece of art, you can do so. You just have to sign up before the last day of April. So thanks, everybody, for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this Kraaft It Live with all these fabulous. I really, really like these paints. These turned out to be some fun.
They are beautiful paints.
Thank you, DecoArt. These are fun.
Excellent.
So, we'll be playing with that some more because I've got another one down here that's drying I'm going to play with. But anyway, if you enjoyed it, please leave us a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And of course, those of you watching and recording, we love your comments as well. So thanks, everybody, for joining us live, and have a crafty day. Bye-bye.
Bye, Andrew. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Andrew. We'll leave on that note.